Hi, I'm Penny and this is Fraser and this is our Level 3 Mechanics video.
This paper has four key concepts: simple harmonic motion, linear motion, rotational motion and circular motion.
There are two different types of questions in the standard. There's the calculation questions and then there's the explaining questions. We're going to talk you through how to best approach these, both of these types of questions. For the calculation questions, you may look at the question and it may just click that you know exactly what you need to do. But in the case where you look at it and you're not too sure about what you need to do, it's a really good strategy to draw a diagram or a picture or anything to kind of represent what is going on in the question. And then you can work on extracting all the information from the paragraph and put it into your picture. And I would also suggest that you label what you want to know in that same picture. And then what you can do is you can refer to your formula sheet where you can look at all the different variables and relate it to what's on your diagram, and then you're able to maybe get through to the next step. If you're still stuck, you may want to think about different types of concepts such as conservation of energy, conservation of momentum, or whether it's referring to something that's in orbit. For example, if you're talking about a satellite in orbit, you're going to want to pull out the equations for the centripetal force and the gravitational force, because in orbit these two forces will be equal.
When you're doing conceptual based questions, even though you're not doing any calculations, it's important to realize that there's almost always a relevant formula that you can use to help guide your explanation. For instance, a lot of the time they're going to ask about how changing one variable is going to affect another. And to do this, you can use a formula. So for example, is the classic conservation of angular momentum using L equals I omega, how pulling yourself in reduces your rotational inertia so it makes you speed up, for example. So the formula tells you this: if you were to decrease rotational inertia to keep the angular momentum constant, you must increase your angular velocity. This has been StudyTime's strategy video for Level 3 Mechanics. Remember, everything is going to come down to one of the types of motion, but you are always going to have to use your formula sheet, so make sure you know it inside and out.
For this particular standard, we would strongly recommend that you become comfortable with these formulas and applying it to particular types of questions. We place a strong emphasis on practice, practice, practice in this standard. We would also strongly recommend that you check out StudyTime's walkthrough guides for Level 3 Physics. Thank you for watching and good luck.